respected Sri Jawahar Sarkarji, IGNCA President Sri Chinmay Argare Khan, Dr. Kapila Vatsyayan, subject scholar, guide, mentor for this project. Today, we are releasing the second and significant multimedia project on Jayadev's Gita Govinda, out of the five such major projects initiated by IGNCA. We have already released, and as mentioned by President, the interactive multimedia DVD on Brihadishwara in December 2013. Other major projects under development are Agnichayan, a Vedic ritual, Devnarayan, a folk deity from Rajasthan, and Vishwaroop, a cosmic form of Bhagwan Vishnu. These projects were initiated under the UNDP funding, and the credits goes to Dr. Vatsyayan not only for conceptualizing, planning, and supervising these projects, but also for convincing the UNDP officials for providing funds for setting up of the cultural informatics lab. The main objective of our cultural informatics is to design and develop content explanation systems to intensify cultural learning and visualization, and to provide easy access of Indian art and cultural heritage. The projects within the multimedia lab reflects the fundamental approach of the IGNCA, which is both multidisciplinary and interdisciplinary, since multimedia is a powerful tool for storing and linking digital materials. It is a most appropriate medium to reflect this holistic approach. This technology combines audio, video, graphics, animation, and text on a single platform to facilitate users to experience our rich cultural diversity. These projects imply an integrated methodology to develop applications to access diverse media on architecture, sculpture, iconography, epigraphical records, textual resources, music, dance traditions, paintings, illustrations, murals, festivals, rituals, living traditions, etc., to create the state-of-the-art interactive systems. Our projects are planned in collaboration with institutions doing pioneering work in this area. The cultural learning systems are utilizing the skill and resources of eminent scholars, educationists, and computer professionals to design the interactive learning tools. One of the major achievements of these multimedia projects is to establish the synergies between the disciplines of art and information technology, leading to usage, development, and dissemination. A documentation standard has been evolved and is being modified in collaboration with national and international experts for designing contents for the specialized user group, that is children, research scholars, and for general interest. I don't have to say much on the advantages of the digital multimedia for a center like ours, and of course, the other advantages it has in other spheres of knowledge. Digital penetration in India has increased considerably in the last decade. Today, almost every young Indian is using mobile phone, and majority of them are using smartphones. High-speed network links are available in the remote villages now. In fact, dissemination platform is ready. We just have to make our content accessible on this platform. The first feature that we have introduced in our projects is multi-layered approach for presentation of the content. Rich interactivity is another important aspect of these projects. Human-computer interface for easy navigation is the core for devising such interface. Varied navigation strategies have been applied in these projects to navigate through knowledge space that unfolds for the user from one module to another. Users can navigate without losing the current context. The content can be accessed in sequential, non-sequential ways, as well as in an associated manner. By default, the system allows the automatic expansion and exploration path depends upon the user's interest. On the database front, with a large volume of data consisting of primary and secondary materials, the technology allows us and easy updating and editing. It is important for us to adopt standards, preferably for the search and global exchange of data. I agree that digital technology has to prove itself for long-term availability, mainly for the purpose of archiving. Technologists across the world are already working in this area. Here the emphasis is on how to communicate and pass these recorded and archived data back to the society in its right context. Multimedia projects of IGNCA are true example of such initiatives. In Gita Govinda project, we had a different challenge altogether. It is a small poem consisting of 24 cantos called Ashtapadis. We have selected only 6 Ashtapadis, and for these 6 Ashtapadis, only selected genres have been represented in the multimedia, but the volume in terms of original documentation goes to over 40 GB for these 6 Ashtapadis. One can imagine the volume of the data if the complete composition would have been taken with all its diversity. We realize that the creative sublimity of this poem cannot be bound within the boundaries of the technology. Our domain experts have tried not to go into the complexity of the text. The challenge was to show the permeation of this text in different parts of India. We have presented the content in 3 layers. Dr. Vatsyayan is working in this project for more than 50 years and guiding us on every aspect of this project. I hope she will cover the content structuring in detail during her speech. We have approximately 17 hours of the video in this presentation. So I'll just like to give you the glimpses of the different layers which we have prepared for the presentation. So we start with the introduction, where we have described the text in brief with the penetration across the India. So I'll start with that. This is about the permeation of the text which you have included into the introduction. Now I'll take you to the another level. And here the, all the six Ashtapadis which we have selected for this multimedia presentation, and for each of these Ashtapadis we have made the same structuring. Those who have seen the multimedia presentation in 1997, they may recall that it starts with the recitation, Sanskrit recitation by Pandit Sampath Narayan. So I'll give you a little glimpse. Then is the text, and then I will take you to the painting exploration layer where the painting, music and dance and schools are presented. So these are the painting schools. If you see it in the left hand side, there are the isolated buttons, and that gives about the group, and then there are the different paintings. I will take you to the Mewar. There is again explanation about the group. And then each of these paintings, now if you put the cursor on these paintings, it gives the event. So it describes the event, each part. And this is same for all the paintings. If you click next, so each part of the paintings you can see. I'll just take you to the other group now. So similarly for the music schools, the styles are represented here. From everywhere, whether it's the painting, whether it's the music or the dance, I'll come to the dance, there is a connectivity with the text. So either the English text or Sanskrit text, English translation or Sanskrit. So one can see the text. The structure of the each Ashtapadi, we have maintained the same. I'll just give you a little example of the dance performance. Here again the ODC. And then for most of these paintings and music and dance renderings, there is the explanation. So I'll take you that part. The same dance is here explained by
Radha
Madhavi Mudgalji.
Comes looking for Krishna through creepers. She hears him. Sees him sitting under the tree. Krishna. playing his flute.
So there is a dance and there is the explanation of the dance. So both is integrated here. I'll just take you to the another level.
Holding the breath.
And that is the interpretation level. In this interpretation level, we have get the interpretation and critical evaluation of the text by the eminent scholars. So I'll just start with Pandit Vidyanivas.
If you want to study Gita Govinda, you must place Srimad Bhagavat in the background. Because it is by juxtaposing Srimad Bhagavat with Gita Govinda, we can understand the real meaning of Gita Govinda. I call it an initiation of a Radha epoch in literature, as against an initiation of Sri Krishna epoch.
And
the Yamuna.
B.N. Goswami explaining the Kangra paintings.
Sort of constantly being referred to by Jayadeva, and he has to bear in mind the fact that the entire thing happens outdoors and in practically every single painting of the Gita Govinda series by Manaku, the Yamuna appears. Discreetly sometimes, sometimes more positively or stridently. Sometimes the edge of the water is foamy, there's a kind of a ring there of foam, and sometimes it is without that, just a sword of green in the background. So there are things which are happening here, which Manaku, in a self-aware fashion, is bringing in, reminding us, reminding his viewer across time, across space, that all this is unfolding on the banks of Kalindi.
So I'll just stop trees it here. What we had tried in this multimedia presentation is that the user has the option whether he wanted to see only the interpretation level of the text, or he wanted to explore either the painting or music or dance or the other penetrations or the recitations of the poem. At this second level, if he wants, that he wanted to see only the Jaipur painting or the Mewar painting, so he can go directly to the Mewar painting and see in each of the Ashtapadi. So he does not need to go through all the other paintings. So that level of interactivity we have tried to establish here, and I hope that the users will like it. Although I'll see that the multiple levels, if we talk of only the selected data in terms of the interpretations, there are only few scholars who could be able to include it. But then the user has the option to select the of his choice and explore accordingly. So that's the facility mentioned. I would like to thank all the artists. Some of them is here. I have seen Leela Amchari ji is here and many others who have performed for this multimedia presentation. All the professionals who were involved since 1994 and even before that. I am thankful to them, the institutions, the UNDP who has funded this lab, the institutions from where we have collected the visuals, especially National Museum, Salarjung Museum, Orissa State Museum, Bharat Kala Bhavan. So all these institutions who have provided the visuals, I'm also thankful to them. Also like to thank Dr. Ranjit Makuni, who was represented the Xerox Park here and was instrumental in making this initial technical presentation, which we have little bit modified in terms of the technology. I also like to thank Mrs. Nina Ranjan, National Project Coordinator of the UND People Project, although she is not here today. Although Dr. Pandit Vidyanivas Mishra, Pandit Kelucharan Mahapatra, Vidushi Sumati Mutatkar, Guru Babu, Ms. Jaichandi Ram are not with us today, but they will always be remembered for their contributions in this project. I would like to thank CIL and Media Center team and IGNCA officials and the staff for their continuous support in completing this project. I am grateful to IGNCA management, President Chinmay Gare Khan, Joint Secretary Veena Joshi, and especially Dr. Vatsyayan for giving me the opportunity to work on this project. Thank you.